Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Lyrical Overdose. Today we have a special guest. He's a buddy of mine. He's a dancer and a rapper as well. His name is Pretty Rico. He's gonna be breaking down a song today called Work, I believe. It's out in his new album, Burgundy Dreams. Be sure to check it out. Yeah, I'll put his details down below. But anyways, let's get to it.
What's up? It's your boy Pretty Rico, and today I'm here in Lyrical Overdose. Shout out to my boy Billy, Billboy Son, for inviting me here. Today we're gonna break down one of my songs out of Burgundy Dreams album, and it's called Work. So let's get into it. About to hit up with the work, work, with the work, work. About to hit up with the motherfucking work, yeah. With the work, work, with the work, work. About to hit up with the motherfucking work. I woke up in this bitch, no slipping, chopping out the stick. Okay, jadi inspirasi di balik lagu Work ini tuh ceritanya pas gue lagi nyetir mobil, I'm driving by myself, dan tiba-tiba gue kepikiran quotes. Yaitu work hard, beat talent. Jadi dari situ pas gue dengerin beat ini di mobil, jadi gue tiba-tiba kepikiran temanya kenapa nggak work aja gitu. Jadi dari situ gue udah dapet idenya, langsung gue kembangin deh. Dan yang produserin untuk lagu Work ini itu ada All Good Music Indonesia, produsernya si Slide, beatmakernya my boy Nile Nalelo. Dan kalau kalian belum dengerin lagunya atau dengerin albumnya, kalian bisa dengerin di semua digital platforms. Better hit them with the work, with the work. Better hit them with the motherfucking work, with the work, with the work. Better hit them with the motherfucking work. I go hard in this bitch, no slipping, jumping off the stage. Yeah, I'm diving, don't you blink, oh. You gon' miss this, killed everything till I'm finished. Oke, jadi untuk chorusnya, basically tuh gue pengen kasih tahu kalau lewat kerja keras kita tuh bisa ngalahin orang yang udah punya talent dari sananya. Jadi basically, ya itu sih, gue pengen nunjukin ke orang-orang kalau mindset gue tuh mengutamakan cara gue kerja, kurang lebih seperti itu. Let's get it, ambil plastic cup, make it double, take a sip, pop a pop a bottle, I like minuman pahit, then I mix it jelas ritual wajib, walau vision blurry menyipit. Whenever I drink, pass the lid on some other shit yang kan buka pikiran, then I murder every rhymes. Yang buat verse satunya, gue buka itu dari gue kasih gambaran kurang lebih apa yang gue lakuin bareng teman-teman kalau kita lagi proses bikin lagu. Di situ gue ngomongin kayak kita biasa minum gitu kan biar lebih nyantai nulis lagunya, jadi kayak semacam ritual sebelum kita mulai kerja. If I want it, I will get it, I can sit and watch, minta yang di atas buat nama gue sampai juga ke atas. Buat line yang tadi itu kayak gue tuh punya mindset kayak misalkan okay, gue pengen barang ini deh, gue suka barang ini deh, jadi gue kayak tanemin di mindset gue kayak gue harus bisa dapetin itu gimana pun caranya. Terus gue lanjutin dengan lines yang berikutnya, kayak gue mainin kata-kata di atas kayak jadi rimanya gitu, minta sama yang di atas untuk bawa nama gue nanti sampai ke atas. You can't touch this flow, you can't touch me bro, we gon' have problems, so you better call them. You can't be me though, now we're not equal, I'm going in raw every time, no condom. Untuk lanjutan liriknya ini, di sini tuh gue coba ngasih tahu kalau jadi gini guys, di hip hop itu the beautiful things about hip hop is nobody can tell you shit, you know, just do what you want. Jadi kayak di hip hop itu lu lakuin aja apa yang lu suka gitu, nggak ada orang lain yang bisa ngasih tahu lu. Jadi di sini tuh gue coba kayak you can't touch me bro, I got the flow, something like that. Oke, okay, udah, I'm ready. If you wanna come at me, I'm ready. Fuck me, bitch, tell me how to do it. Gak ada yang benar atau salah bikin musik. Everybody got their own pace, jadi jangan usik. Next move I'll switch up and I'm coming with the new shit, but I hit them with the word. Nah, untuk menutup verse 1 ini, seperti yang gue jelasin tadi, di sini tuh gue pengen kasih tahu kalau jangan biarin orang lain ngasih tahu lu harus begini, harus begitu. Karena di sini tuh lo bebas main, makanya hip hop itu kayak freedom. Jadi gue nutupnya dengan kalimat kayak persetan buat kalian yang ngasih tahu kita harus begini, harus begitu. Karena semua orang punya momennya masing-masing dan akan berhasil di waktu yang masing-masing juga. First you gotta know where you going. Mau uang yang kertas atau koin. You wanna drama or beef sirloin. Industri atau cuma mau main-main. Nah, di verse 2 ini tuh gue masih dengan tema work. Cuman gue ambil dari sudut pandang skena music yang gue lakuin. First you gotta know where you going. Kayak menurut gue yang paling penting itu apapun yang lo lakuin lo harus tahu apa yang lo mau. Mau uang yang kertas atau koin, mau drama atau sirloin, mau industri atau cuma main-main. Maksud gue sama soal drama, soal industri atau yang mau keep it real, lo harus tahu apa yang lo mau, jalur apa yang mau lo ambil. I can tell who's playing, who's popping. I can tell who's rapping the facts or just lying. Coba salin, ku punya energi all calling. Always jaws up, I don't waste time. So invest it, yeah, I'm all in. Kalau buat gue itu di skena hip hop ya, yang paling ngeganggu kuping gue itu adalah pas gue denger misalkan ada orang nge-rap di lagunya tapi gak tentang hidup mereka atau gak mereka kayak sesuatu yang mereka bahkan gak punya gitu, atau bukan lifestyle mereka. Di lirik ini gue pengen ngasih tau, sebenernya gue tahu lu bohong gitu. Gue tahu mana yang serius, mana yang main-main, gue tahu. Trying to deal with the game and make a meal. Then keep scoring more like in the field. I was not born rich but I was real. I'm genuine with the shit. Ucap fakta bukan bullshit but I hit them with the word. Untuk penutupan verse 2 ini, intinya gue pengen kasih tahu kalau apa yang gue tulis, gue ucapan, yang gue rapin tuh dari dulu selalu fakta. Dan gue gak ngayal-ngayal bohong soal sesuatu, intinya gitu sih.
Thank you so much for coming on the show. Yeah, man. Now I'm gonna ask you a few questions.
Questions?
Questions, and you have to answer them. You have to answer them fast.
Okay. Ini jadi pertanyaan, jadi sesi-sesi pertanyaan.
Okay, question number one.
Look at his face. Look at his face.
Can you show us your DMs?
Show my DMs?
Yeah.
Shit, I forgot my phone, bro.
Nah, your phone is right here. I can see the phone. You don't have to do it, but if you don't do it, then you get a punishment.
What happened if I don't want to do it?
You only find out once I give you the punishment. Okay. Just show your top chat. Yeah, show it to the camera.
I'm clean, y'all. I'm right, clean. Right.
That's good.
But, I'm loyal.
But your reaction was so sus, though. Alright. Question number two. Can you show us your bank account?
Bank account? What the fuck? Okay.
Alright, exclusive on Lyrical Overdose. How much is Pretty Rico worth?
I only got like how much? 800,000 rupiah, but I got another money somewhere else. Right?
Such as your crypto. So you put most of your money in investments. I do invest. All right, guys.
With some shit.
Learn from Rico. Question number three. Cut you through the middle. So there was one line in your song where you said no condom. Like, is that true, bro? Like, you never wear a condom?
Yes.
Is it just with your current girlfriend or with everyone?
I rarely wear a condom.
You rarely work out.
I'm a true believer.
True believer. True believer in the skin.
Yes. But hey, but I never lie, kan? Bener kan?
Yeah. Right. Okay, this is getting weird. Well, if there's anyone you guys would like to see on the show, please comment down below. I'll definitely try and get them on the show, and who knows, they might reveal their deepest, darkest secrets and desires. All right. Well, catch you on the next one.